Hello guys, in the chapter DC power supplies, so far we have covered these topics. In case if you missed these topics, the links are available in the description. As in previous lecture, we learned that in series pass transistorized voltage regulator, it has a limitation, that is power dissipation. So the concept of power dissipation. Today we will learn the concept of power dissipation in transistorized series voltage regulator along with current limiting action in it, short circuit and overload protection to the voltage regulator. As in previous lecture, we have learned the power dissipation, how it takes place in the series pass voltage regulator. Today we will learn about the short circuit protection and overload protection in the series pass transistor, how we will able to provide the short circuit protection. Now if we accidentally short the load terminals, we get a large current that will destroy the series pass transistor Q2 or a diode in the unregulated power supply. Now this is the diagram which we studied in the last lecture, where Q1 and Q2 are two transistors and Q2 is known as series pass transistor because all the load current is passes through the transistor Q2. Now in case if by accidentally we short this terminal, what happens? The resistance across this terminal will become zero and current has a property to flow through the path where it has minimum resistance. Now here if we make it short, so here the resistance is zero, so all the current will pass through here and this may cause a large current. This may cause that transistor Q2 has to handle a very large current, and by handling this, while handling this large current, Q2 may destroy or even the diodes which are used in rectifiers, they might get affected. So how we will able to prevent this Q2? For this, the current limiting technique is used. This technique avoids this possibility and provides short circuit protection. So how this current limiting technique can be used? So for that, we are adding one extra transistor with R3 and a current sensing resistor R4. So let's see what is the circuit diagram. This circuit diagram belongs to series pass transistor, which we studied in last question or in last topic. For today's topic, the circuit diagram is this. Here we have connected a transistor Q1 along with resistor R4 so that this short circuit protection can be prevented. Now how it prevents? Here we have a load resistor RL. Now if accidentally we short this load resistor RL, so the resistance becomes zero, so current will start flowing towards this terminal. Now while current is flowing through here, they get resistor R4, which is a current sensing resistor. Now this R4 is not available in the series pass transistor, and hence if short circuit occurs, this Q2 will be destroyed. And to prevent this Q2, we have used a R4, which is a current sensing resistor. Now let's see the working. R4 is used as current sensing resistor for load current less than 600 milliampere. The voltage drop is less than 0.6 volt. Now when the current is normal, when we have not accidentally short the output terminals, the current flowing through R4 is normal, that is less than 0.6 milliampere. Now in that case, the transistor Q1 remains off, because to conduct or to make the transistor Q1 active, we need current more than 0.6 ampere. Now when the voltage is 0.6 volt, now to get this turned on, we require the voltage more than 0.6 volt, and that will occur only when a large current will flow through here. So let's see. Therefore, Qn remains off. In this case, the regulator works in usual way as it is used to work in series pass transistor. Now, when the load current is between 600 milliampere to 700 milliampere, that is overload or short circuit condition, the voltage across R4 is increased and it is between 0.6 volt to 0.7 volt. As current increases, the voltage is also increases, and hence the transistor Q1 turned on. When the transistor Q1 turned on, this decreases the output voltage and prevent the further increase in the load current. As transistor Q1 turned on, the current will flow through here, transistor Q1 through R3, then again to Q2. So in this manner, a current is limited below 600 milliampere, and hence the transistor Q2 will not be destroyed. Now, VBE, we are talking about transistor Q1. VBE is equal to ISL R4. ISL is equal to VBE upon R4, where ISL is short circuit load current, VBE is equal to base to emitter voltage draw, voltage of transistor Q1, that is drop across R4, and R4 is current sensing resistor. Now, how this equation came? Here it is. We want to calculate the voltage across R4. Now, R4 is connected between base and emitter of the transistor Q1. So the voltage between base and emitter is known as VBE. So VBE across R4. So R4 current, we suppose that the current flows through R4 is ISL. So VBE is equal to ISL R4. From here, ISL will be VBE upon R4. Now, there is a disadvantage of this. What is that? This method provides large power dissipation in the series pass transistor under short circuit condition. Almost all input voltage appears across it. Now how? Suppose accidentally we short the terminals. What happens? All the voltage across transistor Q1, and when all the voltage across appears across transistor Q1, the power dissipation takes place in this transistor Q1. So this is the only disadvantage of current limiting technique of series pass transistor voltage regulator. Now, how the question appears in the examination? This question appears in three types. So let's see how the question appears and how we have to answer that. The first question, it might be asked as, explain the concept of power dissipation. Current limitation in series regulator. Explain with the help of circuit diagram. Short circuit protection is provided in transistorized series voltage regulator. Now, let's see how to answer this question. First, we have to explain the concept of power dissipation. So for that, we have to explain the power dissipation which we studied in the last lecture, that is the limitation power dissipation. So this power dissipation we have to explain first. Then the next question is current limitation in series regulator. Explain with the help of circuit diagram how short circuit protection is provided in transistorized series voltage regulator. So first we have to write power dissipation, then we have to explain this, then the circuit diagram, and then this explanation. Now, if the question is what is current limiting element in series regulator, explain with the circuit diagram and current limiting action in it, or explain with the circuit diagram how short circuit and overload protection is achieved in series pass voltage regulator, or explain current limiting in series pass transistor voltage regulator. So in all these three questions, you have to start your answer from here. If accidentally we short the load terminals, then you have to write these two things, then this circuit diagram, and then this explanation. This circuit diagram which I pasted here is only for your reference, that we have studied this in the last question or in the last topic. You don't have to draw this when the question is asked about the current limiting action or short circuit protection or overload protection. This is series pass transistor. So when question is specifically for series pass transistor, then you have to draw this, which we have studied in the last lecture. That's all about the today's lecture. In next lecture, we will learn a three terminal IC and how it can be used as voltage regulator. Thank you.